Good evening, everybody. My name is Brendan Moran, and welcome to the 74th Annual Walnut Festival Twilight Parade. Thanks for being with us. Like I said, I'm Brendan Moran. This is Dave George. For some of the viewers who've been watching this for quite a few years, you may recognize Dave. You did this in 2000, is that right?
That's right. It was back in 2000 was the last time I did it, and there are so many great things about this parade. It's great to be back again.
Well, thanks for being here, Dave. We're getting ready to start here. We can look down the street, and we see the police officers starting their lights, and we're about a couple minutes from probably showtime here, but it's a beautiful evening. It was a hot one today.
Yeah, it was. In fact, it's about 80 degrees right now out here in downtown Walnut Creek. It's there's 67 entries in this evening's parade, and there are several things I like about this parade. One of them is the bands, and we have seven of them in tonight's parade. That should be really exciting.
Yeah, that's one of the highlights, certainly. Also, Dave, looking for some of the firefighters that come through?
That's right. I always look forward to the classic cars and the emergency vehicles. And one of the things that are special that are coming down the street pretty quick here are going to be the emergency vehicles. We're going to see various agencies coming out. And, of course, the classic cars, which are extremely well done, and they're professionally detailed and exciting to see here. And you're going to get some great shots because we have the cameras and everything is right up close. It's almost as if you have a seat right on the curb.
Yeah, we've got a couple different cameras working today. A lot of guys working hard. And there's the Walnut Creek PD. And it looks like they've got the candy out already. Dave, I wonder if we can get on the list for some of that.
Well, I'll tell you, they have cooking shows that I know a lot of other channels have. But, of course, we can sample the candy and give our results to the viewers as well to let them know which of the entries have the best candy.
It sounds like a great idea. So you have been coming to this parade for quite a few years, I imagine, right?
Yeah, I have. In fact, it hasn't changed a whole lot. The only thing I can say is that I think that some of the production from the Walnut Creek TV side has gotten even better over the years. But I think the bands have gotten better. The floats have gotten more elaborate. The demonstrations you'll see from some of the gymnastics teams, they've always gotten better. It's surprising that you could still improve on the parade, and it still gets better year after year.
Yeah, and the people still keep coming out. I can see both sides of the street here, it really has filled up just in the last couple minutes. There's hundreds of people just up and down the street. You cannot get a space on that curb. In fact, when I got here, Dave, about an hour and a half ago, there were plenty of people just marking off their spots.
Yeah, Brendan, you're exactly right. In fact, I talked to some of the band boosters, and of course, those are the most voracious fans of the Twilight Parade, and they actually got here about 3.5 hours ahead of time. Wow. To scout out their spots, and they've been up and down the street at some of the restaurants and getting some food too. So they've really had their spot that they got ready to go, and you'll see them stay all the way to the end. Even when their band passes, they're still staying. Sure.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it'll be long dark by then. We've got a beautiful evening, and we can just start to see the parade coming up the street. I think I maybe see the Grand Marshal behind that, but we want to tell you, this actually kicks off the Walnut Festival, and of course, don't forget about the actual Walnut Festival that is at Heather Farm. Starts on the 18th through the 22nd, and it's $6, but you can get a dollar off the admission price if you bring a can of food, and I will see you there, Dave.
Yes.
Well, coming down the street, you can see the excitement and the crowd really getting going for the Walnut Creek Police Motorcycle Unit. And welcome everyone to the Twilight Parade this evening. These are the officers from Walnut Creek Police, the motorcycle unit, and they were going to perform some of their precision moves right around in front of the grandstands.
Hey, Rob, has a police officer ever given you any candy as he's driven by?
No, but I've given candy to a police officer.
The Walnut Festival Parade each year with the police showing up.
How about that, kids?
The fans have really enjoyed seeing the police officers, and they know that they get even more enjoyment when they're getting the candy. But the police who are covering and protecting and serving us have done an outstanding job year after year helping them out with the parade and, of course, keeping our communities safe.
That goes for the fire department as well. Dave, you're a retired firefighter. Is that correct?
Yes, that's right. I was able to retire from the fire department. It's great to be able to see the other public servants that are out here. I'm looking forward to seeing the rigs coming down a little later on, and always a big fan of the public servants.
You got the cushy job now. A table and the microphones and free candy, huh?
Well, I'll tell you, if we get a piece of candy over here, we're going to give you the rating on how the candy race from the Walnut Creek Police Department. We know that they do an outstanding job in the community, so we expect their candy to be outstanding as well.
We're looking at the Walnut Festival banner, folks. They're waiting for the Walnut Creek PD to kind of clear the way, and here they come. And opening the parade is Giovanna Felding and Gabriella and Marissa Orta. The Walnut Festival Association wants to welcome you to the parade. Enjoy the show.
Give it up once again, folks, for Walnut Creek's finest. A very own motorcycle.
They make it look so easy to ride at about 4 miles an hour. I don't think if I had a bicycle, I could ride that slow.
I'd have my feet on the ground, I think. That's why I'm not a police officer, though.
Opening the parade this evening are Giovanna Fielding and Gabriella and Marissa Orta.
I was mentioning earlier that I'd had a chance to talk to some of the people along
Please
the route.
Enjoy the show.
And, of course,
Thank
many
you,
of them are sitting right on the curb, and other people know they're parade veterans, and they've already brought their chairs out. Well before the parade started.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, boys and girls, give it up for the American Legion, post 29.
The well, coming into view now, this is the American Legion. It's the largest veteran service organization in America. Post 29 was named, was incorporated, I should say, back in May 20th, 1932. It was named after the first serviceman to die right from Martinez, California during World War I. The American Legion participates in many programs working with juniors in high school to develop skills in political leadership. The mission of VFW Post 1351 is to foster camaraderies among United States veterans of overseas conflicts, to service our veterans, the military, and our communities, and to advocate on behalf of our veterans. The Post is part of the oldest major veterans group in the United States, and we're honored to have the Honor Guard participate in the Walnut Festival Parade tonight. We're going to be presenting the flags and the colors here in just a moment.
And that was American Legion Post 29 and VFW Post 1351 Honor Guard. Thanks, fellas, for coming out. And here comes a very large tractor, Dave.
A vintage tractor, no less, probably was quite common back in the day around Walnut Creek.
That's a good point. You don't really see those too many around the streets. And here comes one of my favorites, King Walnut. King Walnut would like to invite everybody to attend the 77th Walnut Festival. That's over at Heather Farm Park, starting on the 18th and running through the 21st. Come be a part of this community tradition. For more information, head over to thewalnutfestival.org.
There's a restaurant in Walnut Creek that has some of the pictures that date back years ago to the Walnut Festival Parade, and King Walnut is in many of those older photos on the walls.
He doesn't get old, King Walnut.
He's got
Which restaurant is that?
That would be Applebee's.
Okay.
This is the Walnut Festival Parade president, Jim Goonan. He's our 2014 Walnut Festival president. He's been involved with the Walnut Festival for many years. He started with the festival back in the mid-90s, volunteering with the Boy Scouts from Troops 380 and 282. He's been very involved with the Pleasant Hill Baseball Association and served as their head commissioner for 7 years, overseeing 400 coaches and 1,700 kids. That's a lot of kids.
That is a lot of kids. And here we are with Fred Sanders. Fred holds the designation of being the oldest living mayor of Walnut Creek. I'm trying to pick out which one is Fred. I think he's probably the guy with the sunglasses in the back. And if he's taking his time, he has earned it. Fred is tonight's Grand Marshal. Driving Fred and his wife Helen is his son, Drew Feltz, and Drew's fiancée, Livian, in the family-owned 1968 Chevy Impala, purchased from Parker Robb Chevy in 1968. Boy, they bought it new, I guess. That answers the question for me, Dave. Usually I think that if you're riding in a parade, it's probably not your car. But that's not true for Fred Sanders and his family. They ride in their own car, God bless them.
Yeah, no kidding. In fact, that particular car, that 68 convertible, is one of the more rare cars. You almost never see a Chevy Impala convertible in mint condition like that, folks. And you're seeing that closer than you can probably get if you were even here at the parade, thanks to the fine work of our camera people.
Fred was the mayor of Walnut Creek all the way back in 1961, and then he served a second term in 1964. During his tenure, Rossmore had a grand opening, and Boundary Oaks also had a grand opening. And as a side note, Fred never played the course. Come on, Fred, you got to get out there. Okay, who's this?
Well, these are the former mayors of Walnut Creek, Robert Schroeder and Ed Skoog.
Robert Schroeder with three terms.
66, 71, and 76. And then Ed Skoog in 1988. A lot of royalty here from the past political landscape here in Walnut Creek this evening.
You're not kidding. And following that, we have more former mayors of Walnut Creek. You're looking at Mary Lou Lucas, mayor in 1986, Gail Murray, 1985 and 1990, and who could forget Sanford Sandy Skaggs, 1975 and 1977. So by my count, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 mayors here tonight.
Yep.
It's got to be some sort of record.
They're in fact, there are even one more car here. We got Charlie Abrams and Kathy Hicks and Sue Rainey. So they're all coming down the street as well. There's a lot of political understanding and knowledge and wisdom here just passed down. I don't think people understand how important these folks have been to the great city we have here we all know and love, Walnut Creek.
No, I can't really speak from experience. I got to imagine that it is not an easy job. And God bless the people who do it and then do it again.
Well, we're broadcasting right outside City Hall where a lot of the power and the decisions take place here. And, of course, they very involved City Council. They appreciate any input they can get.
You are watching the 74th Annual Walnut Festival Twilight Parade. And this is the Blue Devils Marching Band. Blue Devils Sea Drum and Bugle Corps is the youngest group in the world-renowned Blue Devils Youth Organization. Members range in age from 8 to 14, and no experience is necessary to be a member of the Sea Corps. The Corps performs and competes in Northern California field events and local parades. Drum majors are Nathan Sorensen and Logan Colloy. The director is Rick Odello. If you'd like more information on the Blue Devils, visit their website at bluedevils.org or send an email to Rodello, RODELLO at bluedevils.org.
I've traveled around and asked some people in the marching band areas, because I was involved in the marching band myself, and the Blue Devils are known far and away all around the state of California. They're so prestigious that even the C Corp is well known as well.
Is it? Now, you were also in the band when you were about this age as well. Is that right, Dave?
Maybe not this age. I was up in my high school and college years, but I don't think at this age I was performing anywhere near at this much precision.
Let's take a minute and watch the Blue Devils.
Round of applause for the Blue Devils C Drum and Bugle Corps. Wow. Well loved by the crowd.
Quickly, Dave, if you wouldn't mind telling us, what are the judges looking for when a marching band comes through?
Every band has to be judged on their performance, whether the lines are straight, how the music sounds, showmanship. And it's a tough job for those judges to determine what fits for the size of the band. Each band is judged differently.
We have a look at our esteemed judges for this year's Twilight Parade.
Yeah,
writing down the scores.
They're still making their scores available, so they'll know. They're getting it all down right. Well, coming into view now, this is the Contra Costa County Fire Protection District. It's from Contra Costa County Fire Station number one in Walnut Creek. This is a super fire engine weighing in at 60,000 pounds, over 45 feet long. It's known as a Quint, not a truck, not a fire engine, because of the five function it brings to the fire. It has a pump, water, tank, fire hose, aerial device, and ground ladders. Now inside the cab there, that's Captain Jason Walker, engineer Chris Lieberman, and firefighter paramedic Mike Franchina. They're in the six-person cab. And on every Contra Costa fire engine, there's at least one paramedic. And they have a 100-foot aerial extension ladder, and that's all right down the street in downtown Walnut Creek.
Now, you know these guys, right? Yeah, they're looking at you.
Yeah, I know them, and you can know them, too. All you got to do is stop by the station, or you can visit them online, www.cccfpd.org. And they're welcome to give you a tour. And a badge, by the way.
And now you're looking at the mayor of Walnut Creek. Our esteemed mayor, Christina Lawson, was elected to the Walnut Creek City Council in November of 2010. Prior to her election, she was a member of the Walnut Creek Planning Commission. And in addition to being an active member of the community, she is a land use and environmental attorney. Christina lives in Walnut Creek with her husband, Matt, and her two kids. And that's Kate, age 9, and son Graham, who is 4. Special night for them.
And following them, is next we have Walnut Creek City Council member Cindy Silva and Luella Haskew. Cindy has been a council member since 2006 and was mayor both in 2011 and 2013. She'll be serving her third term on the council starting next year. Luella has served on the council since 2012. She's served her community in many capacities, such as soccer referee, election judge, and nonprofit board member. Both are proud to represent the city during the centennial celebration.
Just a beautiful night tonight for the Twilight Parade. 74th annual here, kicking off the Walnut Festival. The people are lined up right along Main Street here, and it couldn't be a finer evening for a parade.
It's a very unique parade when you consider it starts off when it's blazing sun to a certain extent and then ends up when it's dark and you need to find your way home turning your headlights on. Well, this is the Walnut Creek Chamber of Commerce.
And driving the Visitors Bureau car is Carla Garcia. She's chairman-elect for the Chamber and director of marketing for Bay Commercial Bank. Riding with her is board member Angela De La Jose and former board member Richard Carlston. Oh, and there we are. We're those handsome guys. I'm Brendan Moran, and this is Dave George. Thanks for being with us for tonight's Twilight Parade.
You know, the Twilight Parade really is almost a community event, Brendan, because, you know, you'll see the floats as they kind of congregate toward the center of town. You'll see old-time cars that are kind of, you know, driving around. You know something's up. It's not an ordinary Saturday when the Walnut Festival Parade starts. You know that the town's getting ready for another big event.
Yeah, and the best part is the people that come out here every year. So you see the same faces, and it really is a nice atmosphere because everybody gets together for the one special night of the year here in Walnut Creek.
Well, you couldn't be more right. Plus, when you're driving up and down Ignatia Valley Road, you know it's that time of the year where it's the end of summer, starting to begin in the fall. You see those purple banners up and down the street. You know it's going to be some fun coming up.
That's right. And, of course, this is a special year for Walnut Creek. It marks the 100th birthday. It's the centennial, as it were. And there's a birthday festival going on at Shadlands Ranch Museum. That's 11 to 4 on Saturday, October 18th. For information, head over to walnutcreek100.com. I am on the hook to do that for Walnut Creek TV's Creek Currents, Dave.
And, folks, I've watched Walnut Creek Currents many times, and that's one of the best shows I think we have on the air.
Oh, you're just saying that now.
No, you have a lot of, of course, Brendan co-hosts it with other folks beside Ruby Lopez, and it's an excellent show, folks. You ought to check it out. Well, coming up now is the Pearl Harbor Survivors, and we want to welcome them from the Mount Diablo Pearl Harbor Survivors of Central Contra Costa County. These men were at Pearl Harbor or on the surrounding military bases on the island of Oahu, Hawaii, when the Imperial Japanese Navy attacked on a quiet Sunday morning. It's a miracle that any of these men survived that fateful day, December 7th, 1941. And as usual, Brendan, almost everybody around us right now is on their feet, clapping in a standing ovation for these survivors. We'll never forget the 2,403 servicemen and women who lost their lives that day. Remember Pearl Harbor, keeping America alert.
That was a nice moment.
Looks like they have some escort vehicles along with the Pearl Harbor survivors.
People are still clapping, and they have not sat down, all up and down Main Street here.
A special thanks to Diablo A's for providing the parade transportation. Who have several of the survivors inside the vehicle, or would rather ride than walk. And they're hitting their Uga horn.
I have met some of these gentlemen personally when I covered the relighting of the beacon at the top of Mount Diablo, which has some history to it because that was shining when the planes returned from the attack in the days following. And when they relit the beacon a couple months ago, they invited the surviving members of Pearl Harbor to come up, and it was really, really, really honoring to just spend some time with those guys and kind of just listen to their stories, just be in their presence.
Right, I can imagine. Anybody, they have that Pearl Harbor beacon lighting ceremony each year, and that was especially special for your situation, being able to meet and talk with them personally.
You're looking at Rosie the Riveters with the large number of men heading off and joining the military during World War II. Women were encouraged to step up and fill the jobs left behind. These women who worked on the home front during World War II became collectively known as Rosie the Riveters, stepping up in a time of crisis and therefore making a significant impact on the war. The many jobs they did during the war included welding on ships, riveting bombers, and outfitting tanks and jeeps. And quite a few in the Bay Area here.
And another standing ovation by the crowd in the area as they go right down the street. It's almost like a wave of standing ovation for Rosie the Riveters.
Look at those gals.
Well, coming into view now with that huge cheer from the crowd are the Diablo A's, are a chapter of the Model A Clubs of America. The Model A was manufactured by Henry Ford, from 1929 through 1931. Those who grew up with these cars tell us the most interesting stories, and the kids love to hear the horns. And I think that's what we keep hearing, right?
I think so. It seems like every car has its own unique pitch. That'll get your attention on the road. Put the phone down and drive.
Just an FYI, there's going to be 3 helicopters.
But we can have fun with them wherever we travel. Anyone interested in history and automotive restoration is welcome to join the Diablo A's, and please visit our website at diabloa's.com. Happy birthday, Walnut Creek.
It looks like we've got a minute or two before our next show. So don't forget, folks, the Walnut Festival is happening at Heather Farm Park on September 18th through the 21st. Admission is $5. It could be $6. Oh, and we've got a special flyover now. I don't know, talk to the guy in the truck and see if he can get this shot. Here they come.
All right, turn your eyes to the skies. We've been honored by the law enforcement officers of the California Highway Patrol, City of Oakland, and the Contra Costa County Sheriff's Department with a flyover honoring the city of Walnut Creek.
California Highway Patrol, the City of Oakland, the Contra Costa County Sheriff's Department with a flyover honoring the city of Walnut Creek.
We've got excitement on the ground, excitement in the air.
That just got the attention of a lot of the little kids lining the streets here. They didn't know that was coming. I've been doing this parade for a couple years now. That was the first flyover I've seen. You were right, Dave. It gets better and better every year.
And that was kind of a surprise in a certain sense, because not a lot of people knew about that flyover. And it's kind of a surprise when we've seen a helicopter on the ground being brought through before. Last year when you did the parade, you had one of those?
Yeah, we may still see it. I couldn't tell you, but yeah, usually the if there's going to be a helicopter, it's going to be grounded. So that was a nice change.
We stepped it up this year, folks.
Once again, I'm Brendan Moran.
And I'm Dave George.
Dave George. Thanks for being with us here.
Yeah, we're covering the Walnut Festival Parade, and I'll tell you, we have had the people keep coming in.
Yeah, it's just gotten more crowded. You know, we were remarking that right before it started, there was maybe not as many people as we've seen in year before, but I have to say that, in fact, there's more people. And I think it has everything to do with the sun.
Yeah, and a perfect night for the parade, a perfect temperature. Oftentimes that fog will come in, but it seems like the fog is holding off a little bit right now. People are still coming down.
All right, we've got a good one coming up here. It's the Northgate High School dance team. Under the direction of Courtney Howerton, the team is proud to perform their jazz routine, Love on Top. Dancers on this team range from 9th to 12th graders and have worked extremely hard this summer to entertain the crowds and Northgate High School students at all varsity football and basketball games. The Northgate Varsity Dance Team is thrilled to be a part of the 2014 Twilight Parade and hope you enjoy the show. Go Broncos!
Go Broncos!
It's always amazing when we have the cheer teams come out here, because I was just mentioning, it seemed like the routines were rather basic 13, 14 years ago when I was doing it, and they are doing flips and cartwheels and throwing people up in the air. I mean, these girls and all the girls that we're probably going to see in the cheer teams and the entire spirit squads, all the squads, have practiced these things year-round now. This is a year-round deal.
Oh, yeah. It's very specialized, and they take it very seriously, and as well they should. It looks like we might get a show from the Northgate High School dance team. Either that or they're just telling secrets or something.
I think they started this spot, yell out the Bronco cheer. Northgate has been in this parade several times. The cheer and the flags oftentimes precede the bands as well.
Round of applause for the Northgate High School dance team.
One of the great things about this parade, of course, with the live broadcast here, is, of course, it's being taped, and you can watch it online at WCTV.com. I can guarantee you the 20 girls that were just inside that dance team are all going to look at that broadcast right here. And coming up right now is the next group. That's the cheer team. This is Raising School Spirit. Through leadership and teamwork, we're proudly welcome the 2014-2015 Bronco Spirit Team. The talented group of the entire crew is bursting with school spirit and focused on raising the level of Bronco spirit on the Northgate Community Campus and surrounding area.
Thank you.
the Northgate High School Spirit Team. Putting Northgate on the map as the most spirited school in town. Go Broncos.
I know a couple other high schools that might take issue with that last statement. We might see some good competitive spirit here tonight.
Each of the course of the cheer
and
teams
and
the bands are being judged.
Only hometown high school marching band and an auxiliary, the Northgate High School.
And Northgate is coming up next.
The Northgate High School marching band.
Instrumental director.
Under the direction of Greg Brown,
Ferreira, marching band
who is the instrumental music director, Lindsay Ferreira, who is the marching band and auxiliary director. Also, we have Chris Long, Mitra Esefani, sorry, Mitra, Mitchell Collard, and Kayla Severstrand. She's the drumline captain. The Northgate High School Broncos marching band and auxiliary is easing on down the road with Walnut Creek's past 100 years celebration. And let's watch them now. All right, give it up for the Northgate High School Marching Band. So what'd you think?
Well, they're doing excellent, just like the other band we saw so far, the Blue Devil Sea. They're being judged on the line straight, the musicality, and how they did their show. Marching while they're playing is actually a lot more difficult than it looks. They have to keep the notes, they can't go flat, they can't go sharp, they have to keep the beat. So they're being judged on quite a few different things all at the same time.
Don't forget, Community Service Day coming up in Walnut Creek. It's the annual Community Service Day. That's Saturday, September 27th. It starts off with a 7:30 a.m. breakfast and check-in. And find out more information at walnut-creek.org/service.
Well, coming up right now are the Lions Clubs of Walnut Creek. The Lions Clubs of Walnut Creek representing this evening are Walnut Creek, Costa, Amble Valley, Rossmore, and Ignacio Valley commuters. Many of our Lions are not with us this evening as they were supporting our military men and women at the military stand-down being held at Pleasanton this weekend. These Lions support two blind centers, empowering and enriching the lives of the blind and visually impaired community. They support many projects in the city of Walnut Creek and surrounding communities. They are supporters of the Walnut Creek Civic Pride Foundation, being sponsors of the Heather Farm All Abilities Playground, and the Walnut Creek Community Day, providing mentoring programs at elementary schools, sponsoring a Beep baseball team, collecting used eyeglasses, and providing eye surgeries for children at no charge, and many other activities, the Lions Clubs of Walnut Creek.
It's the 90th anniversary of the Lions Club. They're almost as old as Walnut Creek itself. If you're interested in learning more about Lions, go to lionsclubs.org.
We talked earlier about some of the floats that we saw ahead of time, you know, around town. And this is one of the more unique floats with all the different candles they have and celebrating the birthday cake, probably 100 candles there.
You think there's probably 100 candles on that. I think they're wishing happy birthday to the city of Walnut Creek. That was not done this morning. They had to organize for that. Oh, this is a good one here. We've got the Angels for Minnie's Miniature Horse Rescue. Look at these guys. They're a nonprofit dedicated to the well-being of this unique breed, miniature horses. The goal is to rehab abused, neglected, or unwanted minis that are innocent victims of their circumstance. In just the last 17 months, they have placed 212 miniature horses. Wow.
We hear a lot about a lot of rescue, but very seldom do you hear about the miniature horse rescue.
No, I believe I remember if the Angels for Minis were in last year's parade, but I don't believe they were. So they're a nice welcome addition to this year's Twilight Parade.
While Brendan was reading that, we had a little girl from the crowd walk out. She wanted to pet one of the little ponies out there.
Take it home, I imagine.
And what little girl wouldn't want to walk out there and try to pet one of those baby little ponies? Well, coming into view now are the Walnut Creek Aquanauts. The Aquanauts' mission is to develop athletes from novice to elite, building both bodies and minds and instilling skills that will serve swimmers throughout their lifetime. If you love swimming, gymnastics, or dance, then synchronized swimming might be the sport for you. There are still two fall training sessions left. The athletes are handling our information cards and handing them out. You can visit aquanauts.org for more information and join these incredible athletes in the pool. The athletes come from all over the world to the beautiful city of Walnut Creek to practice among elite athletes and train under a world-renowned coaching staff.
Did you know this, Dave, that there are no less than 10 Olympians on the Aquanauts staff? And they really take their job seriously. And in addition to the competitive season, which runs through from January through May, the club productions of two swim shows a year and hosts a swim camp called Week in the Creek. They also hold try-it days for people who want to give it a try. Training is upwards of 6 hours a day, and I believe it if you've ever seen these guys in action.
Every year around the Summer Olympics, I know that's a big talk around anybody who knows anything about the program over at Heather Farm, the Clark Aquatic Center, that everyone's trying to figure out where exactly the Aquanauts are in the Olympics, finding out where are they, how they doing, how's the U.S. team doing, because they are so a part of the legacy of having such a great synchronized swimming program.
And coming up is the old Firehouse School, located at 55 Eckley Lane, amidst the beautiful open spaces of Homestead Park. Old Firehouse School has been part of the Walnut Creek community since 2006. It's truly a place where the relationships are built and creativity is nurtured. Old Firehouse Preschool, a place where children spend their days learning through play.
Looks like they're singing their way down the street, Brendan. I would imagine for most of the little kids that we see in that are helping support some of the larger organizations, this is probably a pretty big moment for them, coming down on their bikes all dressed up.
Oh, I gotta believe it. Marching in a parade? That's the highlight of my week if I'm 6 years old.
And they're probably going to be viewing this parade online, or their parents will probably log on for them at www.walnutcreektv.org.
Go home and look for that quick glimpse. Beautiful night tonight for the 74th annual Walnut Creek Twilight Parade. And don't forget about the Walnut Festival, September 18th through the 21st. We believe it actually might be $6 this year, you know, with inflation and everything else. But you can knock a dollar off if you bring a can of food for the Contra Costa Food Bank. There's more information at thewalnutfestival.org. Well, thanks for being here, Dave.
Yeah, thanks for having me. It's great to be back here in beautiful downtown Walnut Creek and arguably one of the nicest nights we've ever had.
It's usually really, really nice here just in mid-September in Walnut Creek, and it's a great time to have the parade. And we're not alone because there are hundreds and hundreds of people just lining Main Street. You cannot get a seat on the curb. If you wanted a seat on the curb, you had to get here about 2 hours ago. That just shows you how important this parade is.
As a matter of fact, many of the bands actually had to get here about 4 hours ago. They had lined down at the far end of the street near Crest Choice down there, and they stack them up, and they get them all queued up and ready to go to put a parade like this and keep it running like we have. They need to get everybody ready to roll way ahead of time.
Oh, yeah. The logistics that go into this are something I would not want to undertake. So thank you to everybody who helps organize this parade. They're really building the drama here. Our next entry is the Ignacio Valley High School Golden Warrior Marching Band. We're going to give them a second to come on up the street here, and then we'll tell you a little bit about them.
Most of the time, one of the things people may not know about the band competitions are is that after the parade is over, all of these bands people, all the instrument, the people who are playing the instruments and all the flag twirlers and everybody that you see and all the cheer teams, they all meet back at Civic Park. And it's they're in their groups, and there's a lot of cheering of we've got spirit, how about you business? And they wait for about 45 minutes to an hour or so. And that's when the results come in on who wins the different divisions for the bands. The bands are all judged on the showmanship and the lines being straight and how the music sounds. But they don't always, it isn't like Pittsburgh against Blue Devil C.
Right.
It's usually based on the size of the school. But several of the bands are competing against each other this evening. The judges have to make those scores. And sometimes it's very dramatic. You talk about being dramatic, waiting for the big entrance. It'll be probably 45 minutes, oftentimes an hour after the parade is over in the park until they give the results.
Well, and that just tells you how seriously the judges take their jobs as well. And they've been studying all the marching bands that come through, I'm sure, making various notes.
Highly competitive in amongst the, not only bragging rights, but the rights of knowing that you've won a particular award here at the festival.
They put a lot of work into this. The Ignacio Valley Golden Warrior Marching Band, recognized as one of the premier parade marching units in all of Northern California. Hailing from Concord, the Warriors have marched the world over, performing in parades from Great Britain to British Columbia. This year, the Golden Warriors are preparing for a trip to New Orleans, where they'll march in several Mardi Gras parades. I'm jealous. The band is led by drum major Claire Rader, percussion captain Connor Bowl, and color guard captain Julia Quintero. And let's give a listen.
What's really unique about all the bands we have here is that the music you're hearing right now as we are on TV live here is not necessarily what you would hear if you were earlier in the parade route. This is their show music, so it's kind of unique to hear it.
That's a good point.
Well, coming up next is Rock to Wild Orion Youth Workshop. They exist as a leader in the hands-on, high-quality, on-camera training programs used in motion picture, television, and print modeling for promoting life skills and building self-esteem and for the growth and enrichment of the preteen through 12th grade personalities. In keeping with the spirit of the Twilight Parade to celebrate the city of Walnut Creek centennial theme, our driver and owner of the 2007 Mustang Supercharged 450 Ranch Roadster and officer with the Diablo Valley Mustang Association is Larry Booth of Walnut Creek, along with young actress Haley Olson and Mina Courtney with Orion Youth Workshops representing Andrea Jovan.
And it looks like the scooters are out tonight with Grace Cooperative Preschool. If Founded in 1971, Grace Cooperative Preschool believes in learning through play. Our beautiful Walnut Creek campus boasts mature oak trees, an outdoor classroom, a sensory garden, and play equipment designed for imaginative, musical, and cooperative play. Grace Cooperative Preschool is accredited by the National Association for the Education of Young Children. For more information on our threes, fours, and kinder prep programs, please check us out at gracecooperativepreschool.com.
We were talking earlier on how some of the competition, especially with the cheerleaders, they have to see if they could smile through their whole routine. I think these kids would give them a run for their money with all the smiles they got going.
That's right. Not hard to do when you are of that age and get to march in a parade, I imagine. We have a little newsy here. You're looking at Grace Cooperative Preschool here on a picture-perfect evening in Walnut Creek.
Those got great on-screen performance and character. And speaking of characters, coming down next is Tony LaRusse's Animal Rescue Foundation. They save dogs and cats who have run out of time at public shelters and brings people and their animals together to enrich each other's lives. ARF birthday parties, camps, and scout tours offer children of all ages a fun and educational way to foster compassion, respect, and responsibility. ARF's Pet Hug Pack therapy animals. They visit hospitals and rehabilitation centers, schools, and adult care centers throughout Contra Costa County, offering unconditional love to the people they visit. I've never been to an ARF birthday party before.
I've never been to an ARF birthday party. I've been to ARF. Maybe I'll have my next birthday party there.
Always a crowd favorite. My wife works at the hospital, and when the dogs come in to visit the children and the other patients, that really is a highlight of their day.
I'll bet. It's a highlight of my day when I get to go to ARF. It's a beautiful building they have there, and these people do very good work.
Yes, they do.
And you are now looking at the Seven Hills School. Well, you're looking at the trailer end of ARF, but here's the Seven Hills School. It's an independent day school for preschool through eighth grade. The Seven Hills School is proud to be a part of Walnut Creek's 100-year history. For more than 50 years, the Seven Hills Learning Community has engaged the spirit and minds of children, creating the foundation for a lifelong love of learning. Happy birthday, Walnut Creek, from the Seven Hills School. It's great when the kids come out, but it's really nice to see mom and dad give up their time, spend the evening here tonight, and walking in the Walnut Creek Twilight Parade. Thanks, Mom and Dad.
There's never really a letdown on any single entry that comes in. You have the cute kids that are smiling. You have the animals that are making everybody happy. You have the bands, and it just keeps getting better. We're about the halfway point of the parade right now, and it just keeps getting better as it goes along.
Here's our next entrance, the Alhambra High School. Excuse me, the Alhambra High Junior Varsity Cheer.
Yep, they're under the direction of March Labelle. These are the JVs.
So, Rob, you see any future council members out there? Yeah, that's the future of Martinez and Contra Costa.
We'll be right back.
That was the Alhambra High School High Junior Varsity Cheer.
And next, the Alhambra High School Varsity
and of course, following them would be the Alhambra High School Varsity Cheer. They're known for their creative dance and cheer routines. Let's watch.
Alhambra High School Varsity Cheer. You know, there's probably never been a soundtrack made that isn't loud enough. And they could, I like the loud sound on the music that they play. Well, next up is Alhambra High School Marching Band. Please welcome the award-winning Alhambra High School Marching Band and Tall Flag Team. The band is directed by Julianne George and being led by drum major Kevin Conrad.
That last name sounds familiar, Dave. Julianne George, any relation?
Yes, as a matter of fact, the band director is my sister.
Alhambra High School Marching Band, led by the excellent Julianne George, if I may say. Well, we got, hold on to your seats here. We've got quite a few Girl Scouts and Brownies coming up Main Street here. They're coming in numbers. It's Girl Scout Brownie Troop 32980. And this Brownie troop is made up from girls from the age of 7 to 10, and they're beginning the path of scouting. And also delicious cookies.
Yes, you're absolutely right. Of course, known for their cookies, but Girl Scout Troop 32980 almost describes the amount of girls, like you said, 32,980. Arguably the largest group of Girl Scouts we have ever seen at a parade. And they are not shy at all about waving, and we're happy about that.
A lot of these Girl Scouts being led on strings of yarn just to make sure we don't get lost in the crowd. Nothing wrong with that. And of course, what would the Girl Scouts be without the Boy Scouts?
Yeah, I was a actually a Cub Scout. I never made
as
it
was
Boy Scouts, but these are the Boy Scouts, the Iron Horse District, the Boy Scouts of the Iron Horse District and the Mount Diablo Silverado Council celebrating 104 years of serving the youth of Walnut Creek. The Iron Horse District has more than 50 units in Pleasant Hill and Walnut Creek with over 1,600 Cub Scouts, Boy Scouts, varsity team, adventuring crew members ranging in age from 6 to 18 years old. Thank you, Boy Scouts.
And here, after the Boy Scouts, is the Walnut Festival Fishing. For the angler enthusiast, driving an early 1928 pickup. Are the Diablo A's members, Denny and Dee Desmond. The Walnut Festival Fish in Adventure will be held on the 20th and 21st of September from 7 a.m. to 11 a.m. in Heather Farm. Register online at the Walnut Festival website or just come on down. Bring your rod and reel. Enjoy a morning of free fishing at the pond.
I fished that pond before.
Did you catch anything?
Yeah, the catfish were biting heavy that day.
Did you keep it or did you throw it back?
We threw it back.
There you go.
Well, Ace Dance Academy is next, folks. So these are presenting the dancers from Ace Performing Academy. Located right here in Walnut Creek on Mount Diablo Boulevard, Ace Dance Academy offers classes for ages 3 through 18 in ballet, jazz, tap, contemporary, and hip-hop. To learn more, visit acedanceacademy.com. Ace Dance Academy performing for the crowd, and they love it. You know, with all the dancing, the spirit, and cheer squads, the marching bands, the sports teams, it's hard to believe anybody ever sits down in the city of Walnut Creek.
No kidding. There's quite a bit to do. And considering how hard these kids work on just one activity. And here is the All-Star Cheer Reaction Team. It's the All-Star's eighth appearance in the Twilight Parade. It's a nonprofit cheer team made up of 50 kids. They're coached by Jamie Plotnick and are managed by Jamie Plotnick and Mike Garner. The team's motto is, for every action, there's a reaction. Let's give it up for the All-Star Cheer Reaction. Thanks, guys.
So you saw a second ago the kids jumping and vaulting down the street.
And just when you thought, maybe these kids have the right idea. It's been a long day. Get on the train.
These are probably the future All-Star Cheer Reaction Team. Looks like they're riding in the All-Star Express. Well, as they leave, we start to see now the Clayton Valley Charter High School Marching Band. The band is under the direction of Joseph Scott. The Eagle Marching Band is honored to participate in this year's Twilight Parade. Clayton Valley Charter High School is proud to provide its students with a world-class education, preparing its students for the 21st century workplace. And of course, coming now into the judging area is the Clayton Valley letter holders and the banner carriers and the band, and they'll probably be performing here in just a moment.
We'll be right back.
Charter High School.
Now, Dave, that was more of a free-flowing exhibition for a school band than we've seen the last few. Is that right?
Yeah, they're kind of patterned a little, at least at this point in their performance, more like a Stanford band.
I was just going to say that, but I thought I'd leave it up to the expert to make sure I was right.
Well, as Brenda's mentioned, that was a fifth of our seven bands that we have in this parade performing Louie Louie.
And the sun is setting on Walnut Creek tonight for the 74th annual Walnut Festival Twilight Parade. And here is La Mirinda 4-H under the direction of Trisha Barnes. The La Mirinda 4-H Club provides the opportunities and activities to guide members to gain knowledge, attitudes, skills, and habits to navigate educational and professional pursuits in a complex world. And they also have cute dogs. And a chicken. A couple chickens. And a rooster.
Well, if they gave an award for the most variety of animals per an entry, these guys have it. Coming right after them is Cheer San Francisco. Cheer San Francisco is all an adult volunteer cheerleading squad whose purpose is not only to entertain crowds with their high-flying stunts, but to raise money for local charities. Cheer San Francisco is celebrating their 34th anniversary this year and have raised over $250,000 in their fundraising efforts.
All right, cheers, San Francisco. Let's see what you got.
Oh, crowd, are you sleeping? Cheer us up this morning. Make some noise!
She sticks the landing.
And that's how we do it. And you like what you saw. Wow. And let's be honest, you all like what you saw.
Well, she went up as high as the second story. So it's tough to catch them coming down, but everybody seems to be okay.
She's walking away, and I guess that's all that matters.
Cheers, San Francisco, folks.
Thank you, Walnut Creek.
Acrobatic as always.
Okay, and you're now looking at the Sacklands School, Reach Higher. Just like the city of Walnut Creek, the Sacklands School is also celebrating their own anniversary. Whereas Walnut Creek is 100 years old, the Sacklands School is 60. Sacklands School is a pre-K to 8th grade school located in Moraga that challenges students to think creatively, act compassionately, and live courageously. And more than 25% of the Sacklands students come from right here in Walnut Creek.
And they're working on bringing back the hula hoop into style.
Yeah, good hula hooping skills. Also kazoo playing on the menu at Sacklands School.
They have the lighted hula hoops, which is a modification that's unique to the Sacklands School.
You have to be one of the older students, I imagine, to be able to claim a seat on the pickup truck or the wagon at the Sacklands School, or any school for that matter. They make the young kids walk.
Yeah, you know, every one of the kids that we see inside the the express that we had earlier, a little train or riding inside the cars with the Pearl Harbor survivors. Looks like they were the VIPs of the group.
You have to earn a ride in the Twilight Festival Parade.
And speaking of the twilight, the beautiful shot from our cameras here in downtown Walnut Creek is it, as they poetically, each entry kind of rides off into the sunset, Brendan.
That's about right. And don't forget, folks, you can always catch what's going on in Walnut Creek on our very own news magazine show called Creek Currents, hosted by yours truly and the lovely Ruby Lopez. For more information, go to walnutcreektv.org.
You know, I watched a couple of the last ones you did there, and I know you did that great one on Borges Ranch, folks. If you haven't had a chance to take a look at some of the Creek Currents, take a look. They are really, really telling about some of the history of Walnut Creek. They're well produced, they're well run. If you haven't seen them, you should check it out because it's a wonderful show to look at.
Well, you're very kind to say that. We really do enjoy going around, and the last thing I did was the 50th anniversary of Rossmore and got to meet some good people there and got a couple lessons on how to play lawn bowling.
Yeah, I saw you. The local pro, it looked like you threw one ball and you beat the one that the pro at the Rossmore.
Beginner's luck, but they were very kind to me. There's good people at over at Rossmore. So what are we looking at here?
Well, this is Blodgett's Abbey Carpet and Flooring. So here we have a vintage 1952 Dodge panel truck owned by Larry Blodgett. Larry lovingly restored this truck to match one that his grandfather used for his linoleum business in the 50s and 60s. Blodgett Abbey Carpet and Flooring has been servicing the decorating needs of Walnut Creek and the surrounding areas since 1946. That's over three generations. Larry can frequently be seen driving around the area and still uses this truck to make estimates and deliveries to many Blodgett customers.
Oh, that would get my attention. If that pulled up in my driveway.
Beautifully restored.
Riding off into the sunset on a beautiful evening here in Walnut Creek TV.
Well, not a single person has left. In fact, you and I were talking earlier where, because it's so beautiful out here, and we're providing these shots that are putting you in the front row seat, we've certainly seen a lot of people just still continue to come on down to Walnut Creek.
Yeah, just in the last hour, the crowd behind us has gotten bigger and bigger, and I don't think it's going to stop, especially as we get some of the other marching bands that are scheduled to appear. By the time Pittsburgh comes, it is standing room only around here. And coming up next is the Walnut Creek Marauders Youth and Football Cheerleaders. The Marauders are all about the kids. Children ages 7 through 14 learn skills in football and cheer, good sportsmanship, and competitive team spirit. The Marauders program encourages children to achieve the highest standards of being both an athlete and a student, building character and self-esteem and having fun. You don't have to be big to have spirit, Dave.
You don't. I've been to a couple Marauders football games, and in fact, the smaller cheerleaders that we just had on the camera there just a minute ago are probably more the norm than the older cheerleaders. It seemed like they were so small and so little were supporting the football players we'll be seeing here in just a minute.
Here come the guys. A couple offensive linemen here.
Probably the other ones are probably doing some practice right now. Well, coming down the street right now is Changes Salon and Day Spa.
Next up
look
is
and feel like a superstar. Change Salon and Day Spa Center for well-being where fashion, beauty, and wellness blend
like
together effortlessly. Whether you seek relaxation or transformation, visit
fashion,
Changes and our talented team of professionals
will
customize an experience to match your needs.
Whether you seek relaxation
fashion, forward hairstyling, therapeutic massage, active skin care, and flawless nails, all in downtown Walnut Creek. Changes Salon and Day Spa, part of the Walnut Creek community for over 25 years. Find them online at www.changesalon.com.
I'll tell you, after walking the parade route, and you know, a lot of these people have no doubt had to wait in line to get to this part where we are here on Main and Civic. You know, a trip to the spa does not sound like too bad an idea.
Well, you're right, because the parade is about an hour and 20 minutes long at this point, and
yeah.
Probably a few people that are would appreciate going to get a massage, like you're saying.
Maybe a foot massage. Changes Day Spa, people coming over and giving us a couple brochures and some candy, finally. To recognize the hardworking guys here in the booth.
Well, Halloween's right around the corner, and we're ready to go with our first set of candy. Well, the crowd is going absolutely nuts. What's going on next?
Looks like we've got the Concord High School Minutemen marching band and auxiliary units under the musical direction of Gary Courtney. Unity is the key to a strong school community, so we start off tonight's performance with a cheer led by Concord High Varsity Cheer Team. And then following that will be the Minutemen marching band.
Well, they're going for the Spirit Award, no doubt about it.
You know, it just got a couple decibels louder here on Main Street.
Looks like the Minuteman mascot is on hand this evening.
Looks like there is a Minuteman.
After they do the performance, I was able to find out some interesting information on this guy and how they pick him for that job. I'll tell you right after they're done.
Thank you. the Concord High School Minutemen Marching Band.
Now they choose these drum majors and assistant drum majors. It's a highly competitive process that takes several weeks. And that is the way they get that position. It's highly coveted. And they are a leader in the band. So that was a very prestigious position for them to be in.
The Minutemen putting in a strong case tonight. Very competitive amongst the marching band so far.
Yeah, very much so.
I'm glad I do not have the job of having to judge that.
Very difficult job indeed. As they march off into the sunset, we also want to point out this is the Contra Costa Clean Water Program. That's Mr. Funnelhead
there
right
he
there.
He is.
Captain of the Clean Water in Contra Costa County, mascot of the Contra Costa Clean Water Programs, used oil recycling project. And with him is Frammy the Filter. Mr. Funnelhead wants you to recycle your used motor oil and filters. He's certified, certified used oil recycling centers all over Contra Costa County to make it free and easy to dispose of your used motor oil and filters. And they walk off out of the area as we get set up for the next big part of our parade.
Don't forget about Community Service Day, folks. That's coming up Saturday the 27th. Check in at Heather Farm at 7:30 a.m. at walnut-creek.org/service. It's happening all over town, and you can help be a part of Community Service Day.
Well, this is Los Lomas Cheer 2014. They are on an old school tradition based on the Spirit program, proudly representing Los Lomas High School. They're performing their award-winning cheer summer camp routine. They've won many first place awards this year already at USAS Cheer Camp, including top honor of having the best all-around hometown traditions, a huge honor for the team. They are very excited to be part of this special parade. It's always a highlight. This team is led by head director Laura Londahl, coach Olivia Henry, and coach Michelle Huffaker. Go Knights! Los Lomas Cheer. And Brendan, I was thinking when they were doing the routine there, you know, they're used to kneeling down on gymnasium floors and stages. They're kneeling down doing this routine right in the center of the street. That takes some toughness right there.
No, that asphalt is unforgiving.
Maybe that was
a good
reason they...
Parades only comes once a year, I guess. The knees have time to heal.
And thank goodness it was at the cooler part of the day, too. But they did a terrific job.
And here comes Encore Gymnastics. Encore Gymnastics has been building the character of kids of this community since 1983. The performance teams are an excellent example of just that. I can't do that, Dave. These gymnasts span in age, ability, and personality. We've got beginners from 4 years old to ex-competitive teens to senior athletes in their 40s. Wow. These teams do local shows such as the Walnut Festival, and they travel to international events as well. Whoa, that guy was barefooted.
They make it look so easy, but we know it's not.
Here's one of our younger Encore members. She's walking, and that's good enough for me.
Well, she's walked this entire parade. That's about 4 times as many steps as the rest of us would have to take.
I think we've just met next year's Grand Marshal.
Well, she's stealing the show while we wait for Encore to get set up. Looks like she might be part of Encore.
You're watching the 74th annual Walnut Festival Twilight Parade here. We've got some gymnasts doing their things. That's a lot of backflips there. Don't forget, folks, about the Walnut Festival. It's coming up. It's September 18th through the 21st at Heather Farm Park. You meet King Walnut, ride some rides. Admission is $5, possibly $6, but you can get it off $1 if you bring a can of food. Help support the Contra Costa Food Bank. Find out about hours and everything else at thewalnutfestival.org.
Well, we had the huge team there from Encore Gymnastics. Can you tell us a big program, the way they have the younger kids all the way up to the older kids?
Just a few more entrants tonight in tonight's Walnut Festival Parade. And a lot of good ones yet to come. Thanks for being with us here.
Well, we'll let them do their performance, and then we'll let them know who they are in just a minute.
A little bit. My wife is actually an English teacher at El Dorado Middle School. Good job, ladies.
El Dorado Middle School and Mini Cheer Team. Second year that they've been here at the Walnut Festival Twilight Parade. Celebrating the city of Walnut Creek's 100th birthday. And there they go. Still, plenty of energy after a 2-mile parade walk. They performed the Pharrell Williams new song, Happy, and you had a lot of people clapping along and jumping along with them.
And here we have the Ekelani's Performing Arts. Comedy, drama, improv, Shakespeare. The Drama Dons do it all. The Drama Dons perform two productions a year in the Ekelani's Little Theater. Students write and produce original children's theater at local elementary schools, as well as enjoy a yearly trip to the Oregon Shakespeare Festival.
You know, on the current show, the Creek Current show, there's some terrific history that you guys have done on the Ekelani's and the schools here in Walnut Creek. If people have a chance to check that out as part of your show, they really should tune in.
Well, there's a lot to talk about. You know, Walnut Creek is not that big a city, but there's quite a lot going on, and we really don't run out of things to show you on Creek Currents. I got to hang out with these kids. Looks like the Red Bulls were free before tonight's parade. Thank you, Ekelani's Performing Arts. Go Dons.
Well, as it gets darker, what happens next in the parade looks more and more impressive. So as the cameras swing from the Ekelani's Performing Arts, they're going to pick up the East Bay Star Wars Fan Club. Some characters that, of course, we all know and fear. They're joining us from a galaxy far, far away. These are the Jedi, Sith Lords, Troopers, Bounty Hunters, and other assorted denizens. They make up the wretched hive of scum and villainy. May the Force be with you always from the East Bay Star Wars Fan Club.
Jedi, Sith Lords, Troopers, Bounty Hunters.
Looks to me like the dark side is well represented here. I'm looking for somebody who's not a bad guy. It looks like we got a couple good guys here, but mostly I'm seeing Darth Vader, Boba Fett.
Well, certainly the lightsabers are well represented here. I think overall they seem to be pretty peaceful.
I'm glad for that. Wouldn't want to get on the business end of that lightsaber.
Although, as
here comes Darth Vader.
Darth Vader comes over.
Hello, sir.
Darth Vader is rather ominous when he's coming rocking at you with a...
There goes Darth Vader. He just shook my hand.
Thankfully,
I'm not choking.
The lightsaber.
Thank you guys for coming out. The East Bay Star Wars Fan Club. And here we have No Kill Contra Costa County. We'd like to introduce this organization that's changing the way we think about traditional animal sheltering. The No Kill Contra Costa County, they advocate the implementation of the No Kill Equation to replace shelter killing with life-saving alternatives at local shelters. And they do quite a bit, including feral cat trap and neuter release programs. They're involved with the community and public relations, and they do a lot of good work for animals who could use the help. Look at this guy.
Well, the dogs have been well represented in the 2014 parade.
They have been. We should have been counting. We may have set a record tonight.
Yeah, we like to tell you how many bands come in. We actually weren't prepared to count the number of other animals that we saw here today, especially from the 4-H crew, which had the biggest variety of all. We're coming into view now. Is the Pittsburgh High School Spirit Squad. Now, as we mentioned earlier, the bands and the spirit squads are all in competition with each other. It's all based on school size. And so you will hear some of the most exciting cheers and yells from the crowd, because there's a lot of supporters from all of the schools just loading this, the entire parade route. And the teams have been performing all the way down the route. Of course, we're right in front of the main grandstand where we have all of our high-definition cameras set up and ready to roll. This is the Pittsburgh High School Cheer Program. They're under the direction of Jessica Green. That's what the cheer is all about from the crowd. Each year, we cheer for our home and away football games, participate in local parades and festivals, as well as cheer during school basketball games. For these Pittsburgh High School cheerleaders, cheering is not a sport, it's a way of life. They are inviting the crowd to get happy and cheer. So there's
one of my favorite parts of the parade.
Yep.
These guys really, really are exciting to watch.
And as I mentioned, this group, along with the other six bands that we've already seen, will be moving over to the park a little later on, waiting and cheering in a wild, exciting high school scene in just a little while after the parade. If you ever had a chance to check it out, it's really exciting.
That's when they await the results of tonight's performance. You're looking at the Pittsburgh High School Spirit Squad. They're going to perform for us right now.
Squad.
And here they come. It's the Pittsburgh High School Pirates Marching Band under the direction of Jennifer Martinez-Nerez with assistants Fernando Lozano and Rodney Domingo with drum major Israel Castro. The Pittsburgh High School Marching Show proudly celebrates Walnut Creek Centennial with Pink's smash hit Raise Your Glass. And here they come up Main Street, one of the highlights, and the crowd is excited.
The judging starts the moment they step off and start the performance. That was just the march in phase. Thank you. And there they go, the Pittsburgh High School Marching Show Band. And they're called Show Band for a reason. They put on quite a show for us just now. And following them is the Pittsburgh High School Band Boosters. As I know you've mentioned many times in the past, Brendan, where would these young students be without their parents and the boosters that help support them?
Yeah, that's right. It takes a village, as they say. And we'd like to thank everybody that comes out tonight, especially all the parents of the kids that help put this together. There's a lot that goes in to make this one of the most special parades in the Bay Area.
Yeah, and it really was special. We had animals, we had the floats, we had seven bands, we had all sorts of excitement.
That's right. And we want to thank everybody who was watching at home that couldn't come out here. I'm Brendan Moran.
And I'm Dave George.
Thank you very much for being here. Make sure to see us at the Walnut Festival. It's happening on September 18th at Heather Farm Park, and we'll see you there. Thanks, everybody, for being here, and we'll see you next year.
See you next year.
Good night.